Hello, I'm Olivier from Centech, and I will present to you how to set up TTN and Lara Cloud in order to get geolocation position from the 1110 EDK in Azure.
First, we will have a look at the LoRa Edge platform and system architecture. Then we will see how to set up the device, LoRa Cloud, and the TTN application. In the end, we will do a live demonstration by scanning Wi-Fi access points, send them to LoRa Cloud thanks to LoRaWAN, and forward the resulting geolocation position to Azure Cloud. The LR1110 is the latest chip from Semtech. In addition to the radio, it features GPS, Beidou and Wi-Fi scanners, allowing low-power geolocation of a device. This chip can be used as a transceiver or a modem with optional integrated services. It features pre-provisioned EUIs to simplify production, and an hardware crypto engine to keep the keys safe inside the chip and inside the Semtech device gen service. Wi-Fi localization can be done at any time, while there are some prerequisites for GNSS location. You need up-to-date almanac, less than a month old for optimal power consumption, the time, and only in assisted mode, router assistance position. The assisted mode is the lowest power consumption. All those data can be autonomously managed for you by the ModemE firmware and LoRa Cloud device and application services server. Now, what is LoRa Cloud? LoRa Cloud is composed of three services. LoRa Cloud Device Join, which is Semtech Join Server working with the LR1110 embedded crypto element and the keys and EOI pre-provisioned in each device during its production. The LoRa Cloud Geolocation Service. It's a simple cloud API for GNSS, Wi-Fi, and RSSI TDO location. Its billing model is pay-as-you-go. Then there is the LoRa Cloud device and application services we will use today, featuring modem services like file upload, streaming or remote device management, time synchronization, remote almanac update, GNSS, and Wi-Fi geolocation solvers for ModemE. Its billing model is per device, per month. So, how TTN integration of LoRa Cloud works? The device is communicating with TTN thanks to LoRaWAN protocol, and Semtech Device Join is a joint server securely delivering the session keys. All device management frames and almanac updates are transported on specific ports routed by TTN to the device and application services server. Then, if required, TTN forward device and application services downlinks to the device, but also to the application server, for application data like reconstructed files or position coordinates. The application server will be Azure in this demonstration. First, drag and drop the firmware updater on the EVK Nucleo board. The software will flash the ModemE firmware on the LR1110. Then we wait for the LR1110 to be flashed. It is finished when Update Done is displayed. There is also a green LED under the top right corner of the screen. After that, we can flash the Evaluation Kit firmware on the Nucleo board. Now, we want to get the IDs from the ModemE to register it in TTN and LoRa Cloud. For that, we select Start, then Provisioning. Write down the chip UI, Join UI and the pin. Now we will set up LoRa Cloud. First, we need to claim the modem in the join server to prove that we own it, thanks to its pin. For that, click on LoRa Cloud Device Join, Application Owner, give it a name, create the owner, then assign the free allowance, which is a trial. Okay, and now I can go to the devices page, claim individual device, fill chip UI and the pin. Device UI and join UI are still default values, there is no need to enter them. Claim device. Then we need to authorize TTN to provide join request to the join server. For that, we go to application owner bindings, accept join request only from the list, and select the SYN Networks, Associate, and Save. Last step is to set up TTN network server. For that, we go to the home page, application, add an application, set a name, create an application, and devices, add a device manually. OTA is fine, we're using version 1.0.3, and enable external join server. This way, SemTek join server is used and the app key is never exposed to anyone because it's embedded inside the modem and secured inside the hardware secure module of the join server. The app S key and the network S key are securely transferred and exchanged between TTN and the join server. Start at the device. The app UI is a join UI. And then fill the dev UI, network layer settings, I'm in Europe, then add a device. Now we need to set up the LoRa Cloud integration to the device and application services to use all the modem services in background called by TTN. So we go to LoRa Cloud, device and application services, expand, and we need to set the token we previously recorded. Please also set IR1110 demo encoding because that's what we are using today in the EVKE. Set token. So now, every time that there is an uplink from the modem, it will be redirected by TTN to the cloud who will process it and do the geolocation stuff or any services like application layer clock synchronization, file upload, or streaming. Let's see it in live. Now that everything is set up, we can join the network and scan Wi-Fi. So connectivity, the region is correct, we can join the network. You can, actually you can't, but there is a yellow indicator here saying that we are joining the network. And yes, it's green now, you can see it. So pack, demonstrations, geolocation. You can notice that the GNSS button for the demonstration are grayed. It's because it needs a few seconds to synchronize time. Anyway, I'm indoor and I have no GNSS signal here, so I will only do a Wi-Fi scan. So Wi-Fi, then start. We scan four MAC addresses. We can send them to TTN, and the LoRa Cloud integration will give us back a position. Perfect. We got the location. Then, thanks to TTN Webhooks, I created an integration which allows us to store and process the data with all the Azure Cloud powerful tools like Power BI. So we can create a map or graph with all the required data for an application like signal quality or airtime. But also, we can use Azure automations to trigger application actions. Now, what happened in Azure? This will not be a step-by-step video as I do not show how to set up the database, but there is a lot of resources on the internet. But an overview to show you how easy it is to send LoRaWAN data to Azure ecosystem. For the live demo, I added a TTN webhook forwarding data to Azure. I use a function app. It is a small piece of code. It can be Python in this example. Just connect it to my database over there. Then getting data, if it's a location data, it will add it to the geolock database table. And if it's an uplink, I grab metadata and put there in another table. This is when you lack code. But there is another, even easier way to do it, with thanks to Azure Logic App Designer, Logic Apps, sorry. So what you want to do is to create an HTTP access that TTN can use to push the data. So you click on request. When an HTTP request is received, here you use the use sample payload to generate schema button. So if you passed an uplink from TTN like there, it will be able to recognize and pass every field for later use. Perfect. Now we add a new step. What we want to do is to push data to an SQL server and add a new row inside a table. So we select our Azure SQL database. We want the dialog table, perfect. Then the system automatically connects to your database and propose you to fill the different columns. So latitude, it's the latitude field from TTN, perfect. Longitude, it's the longitude field from TTN. And date, it's a name received at in TTN. With that, I did everything I need to get the data from TTN and put them inside SQL database inside Azure. So I click on Save. Here, I will get a new URL I can put inside TTN in Webhooks. I create a new Webhooks, a custom one. Let's call it Azure Geolocation. The format is JSON. The base URL is the one I just received. Then I push location salt messages at Webhooks. This way, every time TTN is able to get a location from LoraCloud, it will push it to a new Logicap function. Let's try it. We can go inside the database, run. Okay, the last ID is 197, the last data I received. Let's go to live data. I will send a new geolock request. We have latitude, longitude here. If we go to the database, then update the request, we have a new position thanks to just 30 seconds of point and click. We have reached the end of the presentation. I hope that it helped you to understand how easy it is to get geolocation position in Azure Cloud without any line of code, thanks to TTN integration of LoraEdge and LoraCloud products. Please feel free to ask any question in the chat or in the Lora Developer Portal forum.